Someone to tell you you're beautiful. Someone to tell you me. Hey guys, so today I'll be doing my makeup and my hair. Every time I try to do a full face of makeup, it never goes right. So pray for me. All right, so I'm sorry I have been gone for a long, long time. You know, I've been like really busy trying to get some things done. So yeah, but I am gonna start making back-to-back content and videos. So yeah, but I'm not gonna do too much talking. We're gonna get straight into this video. Yeah. Okay, so I've decided what I'm gonna start with. My eyebrows, y'all. Cause that's gonna be the easiest and that's gonna help me prep on where to start on my face. Well, I know I'm gonna start on my eyebrows. I know I'm gonna like do my eyeshadow, but this will help me do better with my eyeshadow because I suck at that too. I suck at my eyeshadow. Y'all can see what I'm doing. I do my eyebrows every day. And there ain't nothing else how to do on my own face is eyebrows. I definitely know how to do my eyebrows, baby. I don't care what nobody said. Because whoever says that I can't, they're just a hater. All right. So now, I'm going to put the concealer over it. Cause usually I don't put concealer on like this. Cause like I use a different concealer usually on a daily basis, but at the same time, I don't use concealer for like a face to blend in with my face. And the concealer that I've been using, it looks like red pigmentation on my face when it dries up. So I did not want to use that one. So yeah. But I don't know if these type of brushes are the right brushes because I don't want them to mess up my eyebrows. Because one thing I don't play about, if you know me, you know one thing I do not play about is my eyebrows. I don't care what the occasion is. I don't care where we're going. If my eyebrows ain't done, I don't even want to go no more. Like, I'm not going to want to go. Unless, like, we're going somewhere that we're going to be for 5 minutes that I could just throw on a hat or something. But we're going somewhere that's like somewhere that we're finna be staying. No, I don't. Not without my eyebrows. Hell no. No, ma'am. I like to do the sharp look with my eyebrows. Like sharp ends. And like, one thing about me, I don't like other people doing my eyebrows. Like, if I go to a hairstylist, trust and believe, they never know how to do my eyebrows correctly. I've never met anyone who knows how to do my eyebrows correctly, exactly how I want it done. Like, I got a microblade done on my eyebrows. And the woman, I show her exactly what I want. A whole preview of how I want my eyebrows to look. And she didn't get that right. She still didn't get it right. Like, she got it sort of right enough where, like, over time I could just fix the shape myself. But how you see my eyebrows right now, this is not how they looked. I got my eyebrows done about 6 months ago, something like that. And how my eyebrows is looking right now is not how they looked when I got them done. They were looking really big. If they weren't looking big, they were looking thick, like too high up. But then it was like a tattoo. So, you know, like you could put makeup over a tattoo, right? I put makeup over it so like it didn't look so thick. And with microblade, if you put makeup on it or water on it on the first week or so of getting it done, it's gonna make it wipe away. And so I just wiped away. Over time, the more and more I kept putting like makeup over that, I kept wiping away like the thickness that was there, and I was not mad about that. Cause she was like, the woman who did it, she's like, oh, you should not wet your eyebrows, and you shouldn't do anything to it, or like it's gonna mess up. And when I got my microblade, which I didn't know this, but when you get microblade, you have to come back 2 times. So it's not like a one-time payment where you pay, you get it done, you leave, and you don't ever have to come back. No, it's like you get it done that one time, and then you have to come back like a month later. Yeah, a month later to get it like fixed up. And then you don't have to come back for 6 months. Like, it's crazy. It's crazy. And if you've ever gotten your eyebrows microbladed, you know how much that shit costs to be having to go there and come back. Like, all this. Like, what? Because if, like, you're like me and you just hate the shape of your eyebrows and you have to get it fixed, you know, you pay the money. But at the same time, you be like, all this? Like, girl, kind of like do my eyebrows myself. Like, what are you talking about? So yeah, when she first did it, I learned that, yeah, that shit work way real bad. So when I got it redone, when I got it like fixed up or whatever, she still didn't do it right for a second time. When I literally changed the whole shape of my eyebrows just so I could come back, and she knew how to fix it up properly, and she still couldn't do that shit. And it was so much pain that she's like, oh, is this right? Is this right? I'm like, you know what? Get me off this chair, because like, you're just hurting me. Like, all this. Because like, she would like do the shape, and when she got done, like when she was almost done with the shape, she'd be like, is this good? This is how you want it? I'd be like, you know, like a couple times I told her, because it's not like I just went with whatever she said. I told her, I was like, no, can you like put an arch or like a sharpness on the end right there? And she's like, okay. And then she kept just messing up. I told her 3 times to fix this, fix that. And it's like, I was not going to keep going through all that pain. It was like, it was so much pain. It felt like somebody was stabbing. Like, it felt like somebody had like a knife and they were just scraping at my eyebrows. And I'm like, oh, it hurts so bad. Like, I had to, the whole time she's doing it, I'm just like, I'm just like trying not to break down inside. Cause like everything inside me either wanted to knock her ass out or, cause like I don't take pain. I don't do well with pain. If like I have a short temper and an easy temper. So when I like, it's easy to make me mad. And when people are like hurting me in any type of way, even if it's like something that I set myself up for, I still want to hit you. Like, that's in the discussion. Like, I'm still want to hit you, bro. It's not going to be all sunshine and rainbows just because I set myself up for this. Like, what? Because, like, when my mom, she be doing my hair and, like, she be hurting me. It's like she don't know how to just do people's hair, like, calmly. And I'm not tender-headed. It's just her fucking heavy-ass hands. But, yeah. When she be doing it, I be trying, it be taking all the power in me not to knock her out. Because when I'm in like that much pain, I be forgetting that she's my mom. Like, I for like literally 2.5 seconds, I'll be like, and then I forget that she's my mom. I'll be about to smack the dash out her, bro. I'll be like, oh my God. And it's like, I know, then I think about it, I'll be like, I know if I hit her, I'm gonna get my ass beat. Because she, She's not a very considerate person. Like, girl, you hurting me. You can't accept that I might want to, like I might jump at you a little bit because you hurt me. Like, nobody wants to be in pain. Y'all, I'm stuck on my eyebrows right now. It's this long because y'all probably like, your eyebrows look fine. Just go. Next thing. Like, but I'm really like, they look fine, but they're not the same shape. And I'm really trying to at least have them where they look the same on camera, but it don't look like that's gonna happen. Cause you see it, like this one is like, this shit right here is not my skin tone at all. But it's an easy fix, girl, I can fix it. But you see this one? This one's more like roundish, and this one's more like a box with a sharp end. So I'm like really trying to get this one to look more like this one. I'm trying to get this one to look like this one because I like this shape. This one is how I like my eyebrows to look. And then this one right here is just like how my eyebrows be looking. All right. Let me see. Because y'all see the arch. Y'all see how this one look like a fucking circle. And I don't get how they look different because in the mirror, they look like they're the same shape. But on camera, they don't look the same shape. I don't understand. All right. Let me see. Hold up real quick. Hold up before I try something. To try and make it look not so round. All right. All right. We're going to go to the next thing. And you can obviously see that I put a lot more concealer on this side than this side because you can't really see it on this side, but you can really see it on this side. But anyhow, we're going to go to the next thing. Oh, yes. So I am going to fix that concealer because, like, I know y'all could see it. I could see it when I looked in the camera. How the concealer on the eyebrows was just not matching my skin tone, and I'm big on matching my skin tone. I like, you know, I be seeing people, they be doing their makeup, and their makeup just don't ever look realistic. Like, even when I get my makeup done by a professional, it's like people don't know how to just do makeup and it look realistic. Like, it looks like your own skin. The whole point of makeup is for, it's called makeup because you're not supposed to be able to tell everything that you did to your face from looking at you. You know what I mean? Like, respectfully, you are not. So like when women do their makeup, it's like their face be so caked up. It's like, I've never seen somebody do some makeup and it look like their real skin. It look natural. Now, I've seen a couple people, you know, they do it nicely, but not where they do a full face. My goal is to do a full face and have it still look mostly natural. Or, like, you might be able to look at my face and be like, oh, she got on a little bit of makeup, but not where you can tell I got a full face of makeup. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all, okay, like, for instance, my people out there who watch Zeus. Y'all be seeing Natalie Nunn's face when she be having her makeup on. If you see Natalie Nunn with no makeup on, and then when you see her with the makeup, ooh, child. When she has on makeup, when they be like doing the confessionals or whatever, and she has like a close-up on her face, you can see all the holes in her face from like acne or whatever the fuck. And it her makeup just be so caked up. And then sometimes it don't even be matching her fucking skin tone. I be like, what the heck? Like, who did you wrong like that? Like, for real. That's all that be, like, I just be like, please get the camera off her face. Like, and she an EP, bro. And she be having herself on camera looking that bad. I'd be like, get the fucking camera off her face. Because, like, maybe from a distance, you wouldn't be able to tell that she has, like, caked up makeup. But when they be all up on her face like that, yes, you can tell it clear as daylight. Versus like when she has no makeup on and like the scenes where they're just like walking around the house or they're about to leave the house, you can see the difference. Like, and I don't say this about most people, but she kind of looked better without her makeup. I ain't gonna lie to you. She do. She really do. Sorry, not sorry. I'm trying to blend this in some type of way. You know, I'm gonna use my blending brush, y'all. I'm gonna use my blending brush. And I don't really ever use my brushes, so they probably been collecting dust. And that's why I don't want to put this on my face like that, really. So I haven't used my brushes in months, y'all. I haven't done my makeup since New Year's Eve. Yup. Y'all probably like, wow. Y'all probably like, wow. And then before New Year's Eve, I haven't done it since my birthday? No? Before my birthday, because I got my makeup professionally done on my birthday, so it was before my birthday. I don't know. Who knows? So, yeah. Alright, so now we're finna go to the eyeshadow. Okay, guys, so I'm trying to figure out what color I want to do. And, I love pink, so... But do I have anything pink to wear? That's the question. Let's see. This tape right here is like really itching my eye. Hold up. Okay. No. I could not find regular tape, so I had to do what I had to do. Thinking I'm gonna go for a brown look, so we're gonna do brown. Where's the brushes? So, it's gonna be like an ombre type thing. So we're gonna go in with the dark brown first. From experience, I've learned that never do your eyeshadow after the foundation. Always do it before. That's why I always see people do it before. But I didn't know it was like a mandatory thing where you have to do it before. You can learn a lot from actually doing it yourself. I don't know if y'all can see the color, but like, let me see if I can bring it up for you can see. Can you see though? Can you see right here? Cause it's like I'm brown, I'm black. So when you do brown colors on black on brown skin, it's gonna be very hard to see. Unless like you got a white light on, and I was looking for the white light, but no. But trust me, y'all gonna be able to see when I'm done. I promise. You're gonna be able to see it when I'm done. It's like I'm doing makeup and I'm not going nowhere. It's crazy. But I was like, I wanna, cause I'm on spring break. I just got on spring break yesterday, and I'm like, over spring break there's things that I want to do, and I'm staying in the house all spring break, well mostly, and I'm like, well, if I'm gonna stay in the house, you know, I might as well make it some type of fun.
Using the concealer to like, let me see, pour it on there. Pouring it on the counter. Bro. So like with the tape situation, I could not find the regular, you know the regular tape that you use to like tape paper. You know? I could not find that. And I was so mad. But I was like, you know, gotta do what you gotta do. So I had to get some duct tape and I had to cut it up in little pieces. And I still didn't cut it small enough to where it was like going to be normal sized. But you know, gotta make do with what happens. So now this, y'all can definitely see because, you know, this is lighter than my skin. I really wish that I knew how to do makeup on other people, because I be wanting to do makeup on my friends and stuff and people that I know. I be wanting to make people look pretty, but I don't know. I suck at doing makeup on other people. I'm barely good at doing it on myself, let alone somebody else. And yeah, and then with other people, you gotta get the angles right for you can get like, you have to have them turn their head a certain type of way for you can be able to get, you know, the right angles. But people just don't be positioned right. They don't be positioned. I'm not gonna lie to you. They just don't be positioned right. And these eyeshadow brushes are my mom's. So I am going to have to clean these right after I'm done, because I don't know when she's going to use them again. I don't need no problems for me. Okay, so change of plans. Instead of doing like brown, I've decided to do like black, because it was very hard to see the brown and I'm not gonna do all this and it not be able to be seen. That's stupid. So I've decided to do brown. And I got some really good YouTube ideas coming to y'all later on in time. I say give it like a month or so, but they're coming and they're gonna be really good. They're gonna be really good and then it'll be really good. Like, I'm good at doing makeup, y'all. Yeah, I'm good at doing makeup because I do makeup on myself occasionally sometimes. I'm just not good at doing full faces of makeup. Like, I'm talking contour, all that shit, because my face doesn't really need to be contoured. You know what I'm saying? Like, for instance, people contour their nose, and it's like, my nose is the shape that most people try to get when they contour. So I don't feel like I need a lot done to my face. So I just do makeup for fun. If you see me with full face of makeup on, it's not because I feel like I need it. It's because I like to be extra and I like to do extra things. You know what I'm saying? You know? And, like, people out there who feel like girls wear makeup to feel pretty about themselves, that's very incorrect. Some females, they do. Some females, yeah. But most of the time, females just wear makeup because some like to feel prettier. Not because they feel like they're ugly without it. It's just to feel prettier, or it's just to, like, make yourself pop or feel like a bad bitch. You know what I'm saying? You could feel pretty without the makeup. No. But to feel like a bad bitch? What? That takes a lot. That takes a lot. Like, because, like, guys, we might, y'all might feel like we feel like bad females, you know. But y'all might be like, you are a bad female, blah, blah, blah. You don't need the makeup. But it's not about how other people see you. It's about how you see yourself. Like, somebody can sit there all day and be like, oh, you're skinny. You got the best body. But if you don't feel like you got the best body, you don't have the best body. It's just that simple. Everybody and their mama could tell you. But if you like telling yourself, my body is ugly, I'm fat, then you're never going to believe anything everybody else is saying about you. You're always going to believe that negative thought. You know what I'm saying? So it's like a lot of females, we just want to look pretty. We want to look prettier. We want to feel beautiful. We want to feel like we could pull anybody in a mama. You know what I'm saying? It's like that simple. It's that simple. And now this brush, it was like a little cotton when I started using it. And now it just looks like I dipped this in water. Water foundation, the one that I'm using to contour. Oh, God. It just looks so bad, y'all. It looks so bad. Y'all can see it? Yeah, and I know y'all probably saw the phone. Yeah, I'm using a whole phone. Another phone. Because I told y'all I couldn't find a light. I couldn't find the light. So, gotta improvise, you know? Okay, now time for the wing. The best part. The best part, y'all. It's the best part. In my eyes, is the best part. See, I be seeing people. Where the brush at? Oh, I be seeing people. They do this to blend out the eyeliner. They put the eyeshadow on top to make it blend in. And I've never tried it before, so I'm gonna do it today. Actually, this is the best I've ever done when it comes to makeup, and I feel like it's really only because of the I got the tape pieces. But you know, I play a part too. Okay, I'll play a part too. Ooh, it's not cooperating. Hold on. Yeah, it's not cooperating. I messed up at one point. And they need to be equal with the sharpness. See, y'all see that? And eyeliner is not like the easiest. That's like the hardest thing to get off. In my eyes, that's the hardest thing to get off. When you mess up on the eyeliner, you might as well erase the whole makeup look because you done just fucked it up. So I'm finna attempt to try to make it look better. I'm finna try to put the eyeshadow over it, make it look like it's a part of eyeshadow or whatever. So. make it look, because I'm getting very much mixed signals from this, and I'm really just like, I don't know. I'm getting very much mixed signals. Comment down below. I'm happy I did black, because you can never go wrong with black. You know, if I need to find an outfit to match with my makeup, I'm like really big on matching. If you go to school with me, you know. But like, I'm really big on matching, so I'm not finna do no eyeshadow. And then like, I'm gonna be so mad if I like do eyeshadow and I can't find a color, like outfit that matches with, because I be seeing people, they be doing their makeup, and like, if you're one of these people, no disrespect, but like, I be seeing people do their like makeup and stuff, and their eyeshadow be like a whole different color than their outfit. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I be like somebody could do their eyeshadow and it'd be like really bomb and it really be really pretty, and they do like green eyeshadow, but then walk out the house with fucking, and it don't even be like a black outfit or something like that matches with green. It be fucking walking out with a purple outfit, but you got on green eyeshadow. Like, what? Your eyeshadow is supposed to match with your outfit, or at least with your face. If it don't match with neither or, your shit just fucked up. But like, if you do that, that's what you feel like is cute, you do you, boo. But I personally don't want to dress like that. All right, we're done with the eyeshadow. I think the eyeshadow is good. Time to go for the face. Now, this is the part that I didn't always know how to do, which is foundation. Okay. I'm really good at doing foundation. Blend it up here with the forehead. See the dots giving very much breakout acne.
Leave me, baby. Don't want to fall again. This just hurt me. Think about it, but you hold me like you don't want to break. I need some space. Just think about it.
Just simply brushing the eyebrows, because my eyebrows have very much wild hairs, and wild hairs really like irritate me. Let's say that they really bother me. So yeah. All right, so now for the part that I've been waiting for. I don't know about you, but I've been waiting for it. The contour, y'all. I don't even know what type of brush to use for contour. Well, I do, but I don't know if I should use like this brush. I don't know. We're finna find out. We're finna just do it. Coming out. I see it. You see it? Yeah, you can see that little dark spot right there. Yeah. That's how it's going. I'm using this palette. I don't like using the liquid one. I don't think it'd be a very smart idea to use the liquid one or any other one. So guys, I did it. I did the contour. And it came out really good, actually. I see the difference. It came out very matte. I haven't done the bake yet. I haven't done it. Put a slight bit more. Like it looked good. It blend in. Mm-hmm. Once I put the concealer. Once I put the concealer around like the edges and stuff, it actually came out pretty good. I ain't gonna lie. I like it. It's the first time I've ever done contour, and it actually came out good. So I'm very impressed. I've tried it 3 times. And this makes it like the 4th or maybe 3rd time that I've tried contour. And if I would have did it on my nose, I probably would not know what the fuck to do because I don't have the right brush for that. So yeah, I contoured the forehead and I contoured the cheeks. But I always leave the nose alone. Because already my nose be blending in with the makeup. So this is a lot. I made my makeup be the color of my nose and my nose be a different color than my face. All right, now time for the bake, and then we're gonna go on to my hair, and then I'll put on the lashes and stuff last. Okay. Hi guys, good idea, good plan. I hope y'all can hear it, but even if you can't hear it, I'm gonna put music on in the video, so.
I just wanna kiss you, baby. I just wanna hug you till the end. Baby, till the end.
Well, I don't want to get copyrighted, so I'm probably not going to put it in the video either way, though, so. If y'all want to know what I'm listening to, I'm listening to Right Here by Justin Bieber and Drake right now. Some songs, if like it didn't have Justin Bieber's name on it, I would be like, who is this? They fired. Like, I would not know it was Justin Bieber. Cause like in some of his songs, he don't be sounding like no Justin Bieber, y'all. He be sounding like a chocolate man, okay? He be sounding like a chocolate man. Like, if y'all don't listen to Justin Bieber like that, then you can't be like, oh, he never sounds like, then you can't say that. If you ain't heard at least one of his whole albums,
then you can't say that. I'm just saying. Because, like, how... That's like me saying... And SZA and Summer Walker sound the same. When... Sometimes in some songs they do, but if I was to listen to their whole albums, I probably would not think that. Probably be like, they don't sound nothing alike. Did y'all know Kehlani used to be, got famous from, what is this show called? The Talent? Like, Do You Have Talent? Or something like that? I forgot the name. It's slipping my mind now.
Keep you in my heart, and my heart is where you are. I still think of you, I want you coming back. I remember when we were staring at a photo. Don't forget the way you looked me in the eyes. And I keep you in my heart, and my heart is where you are. I still think of you, I want you coming back. Call me when you want, maybe I can take.
To y'all when I'm done, because I'm running out of storage.
A few minutes later.
Imagine you out somewhere and a bitch walk in like this. You can't tell her she. You can't tell her she. Going out, staying in the house. Look, okay. I wish I had somewhere to go right now. Gee, I wish somebody would ask me out on a date. You gonna pick me up right now. You gonna pick me up right now. See the shoes? Y'all, and my hair messed up, so I didn't have to redo it, but I had to fix it up because I had gotten the shower, and when I got out, it was fucked up. So, yeah. But thank you guys for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. If you want to see more videos, comment down below what you want to see, okay? Yeah, and I got more videos coming out to y'all, especially next month. So, bye.
You want somebody to come bring your flowers.